We have a special treat for you today on Talking Paw Sox. I think if you think about the Boston Red Sox over the last 10 years or so, there's really only a couple names you can link to the Red Sox for all those years. And one is, of course, Roger Clemens, but another is Mike Greenwell. And Mike Greenwell is down here on injury rehab. It's the second time in 2 years now that you've been down here. And I want to talk to you about a couple of those things I had mentioned in introducing you, and that is, of course, loyalty to the Red Sox, and especially lately, you've really been outspoken about how you're proud to so far have played your entire career at the Red Sox, and really you'd like to finish your career at the Red Sox as well.
Well, I think that's something that's really overlooked in the game anymore, is the loyalty that players have towards an organization and the loyalty that an organization should have towards a player. You know, you start naming guys that have played with one team for the last 10 years, and you start running out of names pretty quick. And the main reason is guys like Kirby Puckett have retired, and Don Mattingly and George Brett. And you start naming guys, and you run out of names really fast. And the game's changed, and I think in a bad way. You know, I'm proud of the fact that I've been wearing a Red Sox uniform since I was 18 years old. Proud of the fact that I got to play here in Pawtucket, and it's kind of a neat feeling being able to come back, because there's so many of the same faces here that was here 12 years ago, and it's just a part of the game that has changed. And to be honest with you, to keep the fans and to keep the fans loyal, to see the same people I see here in Pawtucket now that were here when I was here, to keep that, we're going to have to start getting players and teams to try to stay together and stay together for the majority of their career.
You've had to become very reflective of late, a lot of because people are asking you, you know, how much longer you'll be with the Red Sox. Your contract runs out this year. There's even talk that you might be dealt before then. And I think as you do that, it's funny that you should come here because, of course, this is where you played your minor league ball before you went up there for good in 86. So just being back here, you know, do you have specific memories that make you really reflect on, you know, the 22, 23-year-old Mike Greenwell now that you're the 32, 33-year-old Mike Greenwell?
It makes you reflect. And, you know, playing here was a great start of my career. It's when I realized I was capable of playing in the major leagues. And to go up and have the success that I had, and to be able to play this long is I've got to live my childhood dream for 12 years, most of my adult life, all of my adult life, and it's I don't think you can put it in words, the feeling that I have towards the Red Sox. And it's unfortunate because you're not so sure they have the same feelings towards you. And I know the one thing when I leave this game is I'll be able to look back and say that I made a lot of difference in New England, made a lot of changes for the Red Sox, some positive changes, had a pretty good career, and the one thing I think a lot of people will be able to say about me, and it's the one thing I've always cared about, is that I played hard, and I've got the scars on my body to prove it. I've had 9 operations in 12 years of being in the major leagues, and that's tearing your body up quite a bit, but that's the one thing I want to be remembered as, the player that went out and busted his tail, and if he had to dive into first base or run a guy over, that's what he'd do.
Is there any way you can describe it, though, and maybe put it into words? Because I'm thinking, like, last night, you step up to the plate, again in McCoy, playing in a AAA game, you hit a home run, and for you, just being your body, and to know, you know, maybe 10 years almost to the day, I might have done that very same thing, knocked a ball over that same wall, but it's not quite the same me. Is there any way you can describe that?
Well, I think it's more special to be able to do it last night than it was when I was 21 years old playing here. You know, there wasn't the same pressure on me at 21 as there is now as a major league player. When you play in the major leagues, if you're not real careful, you lose the fun part of the game, and that is because of the amount of pressure. There's so much pressure to perform. If you don't perform, you'll be right back here. And, you know, so to be able to step up last night and be able to hit that home run, it was expected of me, I think. So to be able to accomplish it when it's expected of you, it's a lot better feeling. And it felt good jogging around those bases last night.
You talk about the pressure, and I think if you probably leave any lasting memory, and what you've really done over these last 10 years is, I think you, if anybody, and Roger's done this too, have dealt with the phenomenon of being a Boston player. And I'm talking about that real love-hate phenomenon. And you've managed to deal with the media and deal with, you've had the most awful things said about you, and obviously you've had some good times too. Is there any way you can talk about that, and maybe if you've been able to transfer that down to the other players? Because as we see this year, this Red Sox team has struggled, and I think one of the reasons is because when it got down, it started pressing because of all that media pressure and fan love-hate thing.
Well, I tease Roger all the time about it because he pitches every 5 days, and so he doesn't get to, I tease him because he doesn't get to feel the same pressure I feel because I'm out there every day, and you know, I tell him that, well, it's five times as bad for mm-hmm. me, but actually, I'll tell you, it's what's probably kept me in the game and playing the way that I've played is the desire to prove people wrong or to prove someone wrong that maybe said something negative about you, and you know, there's only been a few bad times. There's been a lot more good times, and I really try to dwell on the good times. You know, I really feel like I've had a great career there, and I stepped into some pretty heavy shoes. There was these three outfielders in left field before me, some guy named Ted Williams, Carl Yastrzemski, and Jim Rice, and those are three tremendous players, and I stepped into a position that just so happens to have the most tradition is in any sport. No one position has that tradition, and my goal was to be able to at least play long enough to be mentioned in that same sentence. I didn't think I could be as good as those guys, so I needed to play a long time, and at least now people are starting to talk about the fact that there's been four guys out there really for the last 50 something years, and I know there's been more presidents than there has left fielders at Fenway, and I'm proud of that.
All right, well, thanks a lot. Thanks for coming on
okay.
the show.
You got it.
We'll be back with more Talking Paw Sox right after this.